Murder plot continues. Daily electronic harassment frequencies coming from next door. 5135 West 24th Street in Laramie, Cicero, Illinois 60804. Organized crime family, second floor hideout. This is in retaliation for after school and before evidence, surveillance of children being manipulated, as well as indulging in the white powder bag substance known as cocaine. Address 5130 and 5132. And this murder plot is coming from right here. 5135 West 24th Street, second floor hideout. This is the reason for the Daily Plan attacks. Joint collaboration with some Town of Cicero police officers involved in criminal activity protecting this organization. Insurance fraud, unsolved murder cases of identity theft, Medicaid victims are coerced, manipulated, preconditioned to react at home to create family conflict concern. Once the victims react by covering up all the windows. This is bright light harassment. As you can see, intentions are very clear. Once I go to the bathroom, intentions are very, very clear. Again, this criminal organization is feeling the heat, as they say, regarding constant surveillance of before and after evidence of children being manipulated to deliver and pick up white powder bags. And we also uploaded a young teen engaging with one of the mules' blue car in the white powder bag product known as cocaine. Pressure's on, and this criminal organization is feeling the heat, and this is the reason for the Daily Plan attacks. Joint collaboration with homeowner Martinez, wife, daughter, son, daughter-in-law, and joint collaboration with some Town of Cicero police officers placed in high-ranking positions to avoid any investigation. Fake home visit at 5130 and 5132. There you go. Intentions are very, very clear. And this is an attempt for us to focus away from 5130 and 5132. The little baby ride along continues. As you can see right here, instructions given to park the vehicle right underneath my window. High-tech surveillance monitor, very aware of my location and activities. So, this is what we have for you at the moment. And this murder plot, this is the real deal, folks. It's equivalent to exposure to an X-ray machine or microwave oven radiation. Over time, cause of health problems, cancer in the bone, tumor, cancer, brain damage, silent incoherent victims, nursing home final faith, identity theft, Medicaid takes place. You can hear our little community gang stalking in the background. Very aware of my location and activities. This is how they're carrying on this murder plot on my life. This is daily harassment. Every time I go to the bathroom, this is what the manipulation tactics are about. Right here. So this criminal organization is feeling the heat and the pressure is on. Order of protection in full effect. the manipulation process ongoing. Again, create family conflict concern once I react by covering up our windows. And on the high frequencies, turning off the furnace heater fan blower, of course. But that's not going to happen. I enjoy my comfort. We are waiting for further developments. And we just don't see anything. It's 9:31 p.m. November 6, 2024, Wednesday night. There's no movement. No movement. So we just gonna, that's our public service for today. We don't see no movement. Well, there you have it, folks. We appreciate your support. And as you can see, the intentions are very, very clear. Instructions given. Instructions given. Daily harassment is ongoing. Constant shocking the brain from any electrical source outlet surge. High-tech surveillance monitor can disable and delay response on internet connection. Can shut down any power source outage. Can increase and intensify light harassment once the victim or patient focuses on the light source. Visual effects set on a victim's eye scope. On and off switch will cause accidents and death. Avoid shiny objects redirected toward a victim's face. Again, this is an insurance fraud. Victims are followed home from work, studied, manipulated, and sooner or later, the daily attacks will be deployed. Social acting, community gang stalking, bright light harassment, electronic harassment. There's a number of psychological books based on these daily plan attacks. The Art of War, The 48 Laws, The Centennial, Mind Games, Community Gang Stalking. Very influential under doctor's care. The consequences are very severe under doctor's care once the victim reacts and is preconditioned at home, just like here, to cover up our windows or turn off all electrical appliances, high frequencies. Follow me on Google Maps, 3 million views on Google Maps, detailed information of organized crime family process. It's a process, folks. And this criminal organization, the daily attacks continue. Again, intentions are very, very clear. All right, we appreciate your support. Here you go. Intentions are very, very clear. This is what they do. This is on a daily basis, daily attack. This is on a daily basis. And let's see over here. See? That's the main objective, is to create chaos, confrontation, concern, manipulate family conflict. This is their main purpose. They have a signed contract with organized crime, paid incentives, family vacation, home improvement, use of cars, and so on. Daily harassment. While sleeping, I'm being harassed electronically. This is a magnetic field equal to an X-ray machine or microwave oven radiation over time. This is organized crime family's secret weapon. Daily plan attacks, day and night. This is what they do. Fear is a very important aspect, preconditioning their victims. This is a public service, folks. Again, victims are being followed home from work, studied, manipulated, and sooner or later, the daily plan of attacks will be deployed. Manipulate businesses, remain in control, silent victims. Organized crime family process. It's a process. It takes time to manipulate the victims, but as you can see, this criminal organization this is what they do. It's an insurance fraud. Murder plot insurance fraud. The younger the victim, the bigger the payoff. The victim will become silent, incoherent, once in the hospital setting. It's very important for the family to be involved. Constant mental health hospital evaluation. Victims lose their credibility. Withdrawal is a very important process to leave the victim alone, defenseless, in a hospital setting. Once they become silent, incoherent victims, nursing home final phase, identity theft Medicaid takes place. Big money payday, the younger the victim, the bigger the payoff. That's why there's a lot of young individuals in a nursing home facility because they think they're safe there. But it's just a ticking. Time is just ticking. And sooner or later, they will succumb to silent, incoherent victims, nursing home final phase. Again, it's very important for the family to be involved because naturally, each time the victim reacts to daily plan attacks, well, it becomes second nature to the family to call 911 as a response because they're concerned. My ex-wife has been preconditioned by Town of Cicero police officer, 911 dispatcher named Anna. Joint collaboration with Des Plaines Cook County Sheriff Tom Dart, requesting to speak to me at 5 a.m. while sleeping, knocking furiously on my door. My ex-wife opened the door, and they continued knocking on my door while sleeping. No evidence, no paperwork. But before they left, they made sure they instructed my ex-wife, if Miguel Rodriguez I starts acting in any peculiar way, do not hesitate, call 911 immediately. This is called preconditioning their victims to react. Again, this criminal organization is responding to after school and before children manipulation. And we also uploaded two videos of an underage teen after school at night indulging in the white powder bag substance known as cocaine with the mule blue car. So we are waiting for further developments. At command signal, see, he was instructed to go back in. He was in the vehicle. This high-tech surveillance monitor is very aware of my location and activities. See how he is right there? See that? And there he goes again. So there's a constant moving back and forth, back and forth. This is social acting. There's constant moving back and forth, back and forth, on command signal. He's being instructed to do this now. He's not going anywhere. He's just going in and out, in and out, in and out. Now, I believe the reasoning for this, all we have to do is wait and see. What's the purpose? Because we have him on video running in and out. What's the urgency of him coming out in the cold and going inside the vehicle and then going back in? Is he drug dealing from right there? Who's to say? The car is not on, so how is he staying warm? What's the purpose for him running in and out of his apartment? Again, the car is not on. He's inside a cold vehicle. So we are watching. It's a surveillance. 9:42 p.m. Public view. November 6, 2024, Tuesday night. Community gang stalking. You heard it in the background. So we have community gang stalking. We have social acting here in front. He continues to bait, focus, follow, attention span. Every time I approach my window. High-tech surveillance monitor, very aware of my location and activities. This is how they're carrying on this murder plot on my life, electronically. This is an advantage, a surprise advantage, once I react by approaching the window. Daily plan attacks, and this is one of them. We are waiting for further developments, and so far he's inside a cold vehicle. The car's not running, he's not warm. What's the reasoning for running out of his apartment on command signal? Bait, focus, follow, attention span. At work? We shall see. What's the reasoning behind this social acting? There has to be a purpose. I understand some people cannot sleep, but going outside is not one of them. Watch TV, but again, going outside, that doesn't seem normal in the cold. He is inside a cold car, not running, no heat. And he was nice and warm inside his apartment. We should see. We're going to continue our surveillance. It's 9:45 p.m. We are standing by. The bright light harassment, as you can see, continues from next door. And we're just going to be more vigilant. We're just going to be more vigilant and see. See what's going on. He's still inside a cold vehicle. No movement. He's just waiting for further instructions. He's just sitting inside a cold vehicle. Time. It's 9:46 p.m. No movement. We shall see. Time. It's 9:47 p.m. We're just gonna keep it rolling. We're gonna continue our surveillance. She'll see. Bright light harassment. As soon as I turned around, bright light harassment. We just gotta keep it rolling and find out what's going on. Where that harassment continues from next door and electronic harassment. Don't see anything. Nope, don't see anything. I'm going back to sleep. Ah, right there, right from again. So that's crack timing. It is just timing. And right after harassment in the kitchen. All right, good night. Going back to sleep. verbal harassment.
I guess they went to sleep. I guess they went to sleep, guys. It's 10:31 p.m. 10:31 p.m. Yeah. I guess that's how she wrote. Don't really see anything. Bright light harassment continues. Intentions are very clear. And it's 10:32 p.m. Okay. Moving on. Going back to sleep.